this concept of sort of software being free has been around for a long time, but Richard Stallman is sort of considered as the person who really popularized the idea and took it mainstream and, you know, led the revolution. Quite simply put, the idea is that, you know, software should be free in the sense that of freedom, and not free in the sense of, you know, as the expression goes, free as in beer, free as in speech. So the idea that I can inspect the software that I'm getting, I can look at it, I can modify it, and I can make it do what I want, is a very powerful idea. And we've seen communities come together and operating systems, you know, Linux has come together and so many large projects. So finally, at the end of the day, you know, someone who uses software wants to have some kind of a support for it, right? The open source software that's put up on the internet by some hobbyist is not going to achieve what a business necessarily wants. And open source business models are usually formed when, you know, sort of in meetings arbitrage, right? Taking what's out there that you might have created and put as open source or someone else might have, and meeting the needs of the business that wants to use it and delivering, you know, higher value at lower cost, at, you know, and so on and so forth. So that's where open source business models exist. A lot of it used to be sort of, you know, support driven, consulting driven, but increasingly we are seeing open source business models that are following, you know, the software as a service kind of an approach. And, you know, that's the new models will definitely emerge. Well, I would claim that everything useful should be free. You know, we didn't start Julia from, you know, in order to make money. We started Julia because we wanted to build something that we thought we wanted as researchers, scientists, engineers, so on and so forth, for our own work. And, you know, when other people found it to be useful, it became a large community. And the benefit is, you know, you contribute a little to it and you get back a lot in return. So that's a pretty good deal, I would say. But these things are not at odds with each other. You can have a business, an open source business that addresses the needs of other businesses. Your software can still be free in the sense of free speech, as well as free beer, you know, build a large thriving community of contributors and users around it. And it's just, you know, I've learned so much out of it, which I would have never learned otherwise. I'd never want to sort of change my view on these things.